welcome back to the channel. Before we start this video, I just want to clear up a few things. I apologise for not posting a video last week. I actually filmed a video with my Focus ST, but I wasn't happy with it, so I didn't post it. Number two, you probably see the abomination there. The kitchen's finally getting done, so it's just to stop all the dust and that getting into the lounge. Number three, the tank is quite cloudy at the moment. Because I've just done a water change, so I apologize for that, but it's just a perfect time for me to do this video. So yeah, today we're going to talk about my lighting. So they are AI Freshwater Primes. They're quite cool lights. Not many people use them, I don't think. I don't see a lot of it on YouTube, so I thought I'd just do a review and to show you how awesome they are. So yeah, let's get into it. Right guys, before I show you my lights, I just wanted to show you a few specs. So they don't actually do my lights anymore. They've slightly upgraded it, but I think personally it's quite minute. So if you can pick up some cheap AI Freshwater Prime HDs, then go for it. Like, I think normally they are £200 each. I got two and two goosenets for £190. And they were pretty much brand new, so I got steel really. So I basically got two lights for the price of one. So I was dead chuffed about that. So they're made by a company called Aqua Illuminations. They're quite well known for reef aquariums. So as you can see, they do a reef version, a freshwater, a fuge, I think that's called, and a sole. I think the fuge is to do with growing stuff in your sump for a reef tank. I'm not sure what a sole is. I'm not really into the whole reef thing. I'd love to get into it, but that's a story for another day. That's just showing you the colour spectrum of what the LEDs can do. That's quite cool. Normally LEDs have like a lot of blues and then they dip right down, so that's quite even. So yeah, new to the new model is a dedicated moonlight. Just showing you the lens there, as it's quite different. The main competitors, obviously Kessel's got loads of LEDs and just one lens, so that's how you get the shimmer effect. You do get a shimmer effect on these, but see, it's got multiple lenses, and it tells you how many LEDs you got. So you got 6 cool white, 4 warm white, 2 blue, 1 photo red, 1 green, and 1 moonlight. I wouldn't say it's the world's most popular freshwater LEDs, maybe in America, but in Europe I'd probably say either Fluval or Twin Star are quite popular. So yeah, the good thing about this, that it's got a really, really good app. I'll show you that in depth in a second. So these are the different mounts, so I don't have that mount. You can have like, that's like an aluminium mount. You can have it hanging from the ceiling. This is what I've got. It can have a flexible arm. I've got that in the 18 inch, and I'll show you how I mounted it in a second, because I don't have a rimless aquarium, and that's what they're designed for. Right, so it's got the technical specs, and there's a comparison from the Prime HDs to the Kessel A160 WE Tunis Blues. It's quite cool. My friend's got some A360s, so they're basically the most expensive Kessels you can buy. When lockdown's over, he's going to bring his Kessels over and we're going to do like a review. I really want to try and get power meter, but we'll just have to see about that. I want to try rent one. So saying peak power at 24 inches. This is in open air, so it's not measured with water. It's saying 93 power. Obviously I don't know how accurate that is. 44 average power over area. This is from one single light unit, energy consumption. So yeah, the primes use more energy. So I've got two, and they're 100 watt between them. So I was pretty sure the fixtures, they're actually ramping down now. So they're quite nice. I really like the little illuminated symbols on the top. So one's a parent and one's a child, basically. That's how they call it. It's a bit weird. Yeah, they're really small. One thing I kind of don't like, they're slightly noisy. I don't know if you can hear the fans now. And also on the new one, you can remove this. You can just unclip it. What you find is it gets absolutely covered in dust. So sometimes you have to take it apart. Yeah, so the goosenecks, I'm gonna clip on your side of your tank like this. All I did was, as I took the gooseneck apart, try so I can see it, and I literally screwed it to the wall, which I think is better. It looks a bit cleaner. One thing I do like as well, they are these nice little cable ties, like tidies, not cable ties, sorry. And they just look really good. So it looks really nice and neat. One thing I found that is hard is try bend these arms straight and get them the same height. I quite like suspended lights. I think I'm gonna get them eventually. I think I'm gonna get a Jihiros Vivid 2, or Jihiros, sorry. Hopefully when the kitchen's done, I want to put another tank in there, like an Iragumi setup, and I might put a Jihiros on there. So yeah, we'll just show you for the app now. I show you all the different features. So it's called My AI. Just load it up. It's on Wi-Fi. So this is your main screen. So you've got a schedule. All on, all off. So try to get to the side so you can see the tank as well. Right, so all off, all on, bang, it's like full power, and schedule. So, I don't know if you've noticed as well, Felipe Oliveira uses these on his big tanks, Aquaflora, really cool on the massive tanks. He's quite impressed with these lights too. I've actually spoke to him directly about the settings. The one thing about these lights, as I'll show you now, so you also have a schedule here. You can do your timing, so it's got a built-in timer. You can ramp up and ramp down. So there's these little dots here. So if you click on the dots, so my ramp up is 3:30. The lights go max power at 4. I don't really like massive ramp ups personally at the moment, and they start ramping down at 9:30. We'll change that actually. There you go. So you just drag the dots over like that. And if you just saw that, I just did that dot over. Yeah, and then they go off at 10:30. So for a beginner, it's really complicated. So what you do is, if I just click here, click on 4, and you press the edit. So you can literally control every single color. So you can slide these up and down to what you want, which is quite complicated. You can also do an easy mode. So you just press this button at the top, choose what color temperature you want, and then you just change the intensity, just like that, on a little wheel. So you can go 5,000 Kelvin, which is super red, 100%. We can go to 20,000 Kelvin, which is super blue. And then sunlight is 6,500. Personally, I think it's a 2 orange. Oh, the camera's doing it quite well of changing the colour. But they're quite orange. And then it tells you this side, the wattage. So go back. And you also, again, do manual. Same thing. You can adjust them. Like normal, but auto's the best. So the most annoying thing I'd say about these lights is wicked to have all this customizability. But if you just want to plug the lights in and go, yeah, you can do the 11,000 Kelvin. But you don't know what reds and blues you're getting. You can get a preset off AI's website called the Signature Series, and it's a preset done by a certain person. And this is a person called Lewis Gregory, I think it is. He is owns Octopus 8 in Yorkshire, I think. Or Hull, sorry. But yeah, there's only one preset. And there's like 8 marine presets, which is really annoying considering they've launched this product. So I reached out to Aquaflora and basically asked for their schedule. I'll share my schedule down below. But yeah, give these lights a try. For the money, I think they're wicked. Like before, I had Fluval Fresh and Planted 2.0s. Obviously, they have the 3 now, which has got customizability as well. The 2s were good. I actually had one on this tank for a few months on my old scape, and it just wasn't doing it. But this light seems to grow stuff really well. I've got HC carpet, which is really demanding carpet. Grows it like a treat. Before I had the Ludwigia palustris, and it's getting quite red. That's more to do with fertilizer though than the lights. But yeah, lights do help. So yeah, just give it a try. Like it's really cool that you've got this app, and like you can just click on that. So it's really hard to do behind the camera. So you edit, and if you want, try it in the back. More blues, less blues. Oh, sorry, less blues. More reds. They are really cool. So yeah, definitely recommend you checking them out. Thanks for watching the video, guys. I hope you'd like what I do, and I hope you like my content. Yeah, so if you enjoy it, like and subscribe. Also, be sure to check out my Instagram page. It's at Fish Talk. I post one car photo and one aquascape a day. Yeah, and be sure to check out these lights. I'll put them in the link in the description below, and I'll also put my schedule for my lights in the description below. I'm currently got a few algae issues. They're on half settings, but I'll put the ones in on full settings. So yeah, cheers guys.